But thank you guys for coming. Like I mentioned, this should only be about 40, 45 minutes, depending on questions. I see a lot of you guys have notebooks. Great. Take as much notes as you want. But if you don't have a piece of paper or a computer or anything, don't worry about it, because the reason I have you guys check off the list is so I can email you later, probably this evening or if not first thing tomorrow morning, because I will be on an airplane to this evening going home finally. So in that case, I'll email you a PDF version of this slide presentation and then some additional information. And then if you have questions, we can start communication back and forth. I'm a really laid-back presenter. I feel like if you make it too black and white that people don't get involved. I want you guys to get involved. I want you guys to ask questions. I'm here in person. I know when I go to a presentation, I don't ask questions. 2 weeks later, I think of it, but then I forget to email. Then you guys are sitting there and you don't have the answer to your question. So please feel free. Again, if we're running out of time, I will keep questions towards the end. But that's pretty much all to get you guys started. And for most of you, I got to introduce myself. I'm Lauren Hill, not only your presenter today, but your account rep. So if you have questions tomorrow, next week, by all means, give me a call. At the end of the month, I will have my first vacation of the year, and I'm going to Cabo. So if you want to call me at the end of the month, I will not answer. Somebody else will. So get those questions in, but even when I get back, I will be here. So, and also, too, don't need to write down my information, because one, you guys probably have 40,000 emails from me, and two, you probably all have my business card. There we go. And it's going too fast. Hold on, guys. What I'm seeing here is whatever. It's not the same, but it's okay. So let me tell you a little bit about ListHub. Since some of you are pretty familiar with it, I want to give you guys like kind of a core background. ListHub and all these several other products have been owned and operated off and on throughout the last several years with Move, Inc., which Move, Inc. got acquired by News Corp. The best way I like to explain this, it is basically like Daddy Warbucks adopting us and giving us the opportunity to better our products, to help you guys. I mean, you guys get calls, emails, bombarded all the time. You go to conferences. You have hundreds of different web vendors and technology products that you guys get to use. The great thing about Move, Inc. is we have basically a suite of real estate professional technologies that can handle any and everything that you need. But three of the things that I want to talk about today, if it works, I'm sorry guys, I don't know why my clicker's not working. There we go. Is ListHub, Five Street, and Market Snapshot. Do any of you guys have a upgraded ListHub account or Five Street or Market Snapshot as a raise of hands? Okay, a few? Okay. So this might be a refresher for you guys as well, but these products are also offered through your, obviously through the whole Move, Inc. umbrella, but also because you guys are affiliated with your MLS. So we will go through these three main products, and then at the very end of the presentation, we will talk about any of the upgraded packages we have. But of course, the ListHub partnership, the basic ListHub dashboard, is free of charge. So the next several slides when I go into, it's going to be something that's offered to you guys free. I looked up several accounts before I got here. Majority of the brokerages in this MLS have taken the initiative to go in there and pick and choose where you want your listings to go, which will make more sense when we jump into it since we'll be syndicating your listings. So first and foremost, all of the products we're going to talk about today, and really all of the products underneath the Move, Inc. umbrella, are really the center focus of our business is the realtor. The reason our products get better is because we get feedback from brokers and agents across the country. We answer questions that you guys need. If you guys have an issue and think that this is something that needs to be addressed, we evolve with you all. So throughout this presentation, these products are really to help service you, to really kind of take some stress off your shoulders, maybe help you kind of in this industry alone and maybe like consolidate your leads and help you advertise your listing. So we're going to go through any and every kind of issue you may or may not have in this industry, and hopefully these several products will help you with all of that. Technology. We all know that technology has drastically changed this industry. I got to speak to most of you were in the room when I was talking about how I've grown up in this industry. And for many, many years, there was no MLS. There was no Realtor.com or Zillow or any site. Basically, you had to go to a realtor to look at listings. So you can see over the past 14 plus years, almost 90% of sellers sell their homes with a real estate license like a broker or an agent. And the same thing with buying properties. One component that I always like to involve in this presentation, which was a quote that we got from one of our presenters back at a conference, I think about a year, year and a half ago, is we always get feedback that we think, or from agents that say, is technology ever going to replace us? Well, I don't think technology will ever replace the real estate professional. However, the speaker said, you know, technology will not replace the agent, but technology that's used by an agent, so an agent who's very tech savvy, could replace someone who doesn't. So again, throughout this presentation, I want to hound on the importance of advertising your listings online and using any tech services that you're interested in to your advantage. So here are the four puzzle pieces or components that I think kind of round up every level of participation when it comes to a client. So first and foremost, how are you going to help your sellers get their listings sold, and how are you going to generate leads? You're going to help them by obviously exposing their listings, advertising their listings online. Once you advertise those listings online, what comes after? Hopefully leads, people interested in that property. So how are we going to help you guys route those leads, consolidate them in one place, you know, respond to them in a quickly matter, and basically get that lead to become your client, whether it's for a lifetime or to purchase a home or sell a home or whatever the case may be. Then client tools, you have people you've worked with in the past, you have people you sold a home to last month, last year, you have current sellers. So how are you going to constantly be in communication? I mean, you might have, you know, a Rolodex of 50 people you contact or have contacted with, or maybe you have 500 people in the last 20 years that you've contacted with. Out of curiosity, who's been in this industry longer than like 20, 25 years? Quite a few of you. So you probably have a pretty long Rolodex of people that you sold homes to over the last several years. So how do you keep that client communication with them? And then real-time reporting. If you're advertising your listings online, you are spending the marketing dollars potentially on maybe becoming a pro agent on one of these websites. We want to make sure that you guys can see the value that those sites are providing, and then also to see how you're functioning as a whole brokerage. Like, are you being able to compete with other brokerages in the area? So all of these we'll go through today. All of our products are pretty much going to hit all of these different puzzle pieces. But the first one I really want to jump into, actually, let's see if this is quicker. That might be quicker, is how we're going to generate leads. How are we going to get exposure of your listings? Well, with ListHub, with our ListHub basic package, it is at no cost to the broker. It gives you the opportunity to showcase or advertise, whatever word you want to use, your entire office's listing on a network of 900 websites. Now, some of you might be fairly familiar with your ListHub dashboard and see usually a 70, 75 publisher number. Well, we do have 70 plus publishers within our network. But a lot of sites like HomeFinder or Homes.com actually power additional maybe regional websites or additional real estate websites. So when your listing gets to HomeFinder, it actually trickles to 100, 200 plus sites. So that's where we have the over 900 websites where we actually advertise your listings. To give you a little background about the power of data that we have that we're distributing to all of these MLSs, we have about 650 MLSs connected with ListHub. So we're talking about a lot of data that we get to push out to these publishers. We send out on average 3.3 million listings a day, and to kind of give you a retrospect in a whole year of what we have offered to our real estate professionals is 7.8 billion page views. So that's actually somebody clicking on a listing on a realtor.com, a HomeFinder, any publisher we have within our network. We generated over 18 million leads last year to all of the brokerages and agents that utilize ListHub, which averaged out about 50 leads per day. So this is going to be a way for you guys at no cost to get exposure to all these 900 websites, and I will show you how this works. So you guys, obviously, everyone sitting in here today and all of your agents in the office enter your listings into the MLS. It's the most accurate source of information because it's where you keep price adjustments, you add more photos, flag it as an open house. It's where you update everything. Well, ListHub is already integrated and has been integrated into your MLS for some time. We take all the entire office's listings, so not just yours, every single listing agent in your office and all the listings within that inventory. We pull it from the MLS and put it into their broker dashboard. Now, this is one of the reasons we separate the broker and agent classes, because I really want to go into the broker-controlled platform that ListHub has. As the managing broker, broker owner, you all have complete control of where your listings go. So under your broker dashboard, that is where you can select or deselect any of the sites within our network to say, I want my listings to go here, or I don't want my listings to go here. There's some other components that we have under the basic ListHub dashboard for the broker that I'll go over. But so we pull all those listings from the MLS. We pull 4 times a day, so pretty much we're going to catch any of your updates throughout the day and update all of these sites, which obviously is a benefit because you know none of your listings will be stale. You won't have a listing that had a price adjustment several weeks ago and is still inaccurate on any of these sites. We will update all of that for you. But it's also secure. So once we get all of those listings from the MLS into your broker dashboard, you do not have to do a thing. We will then push it to all of those 70-plus publishers with that extended network of up to 900 sites on your behalf, but we make sure that your data is safe and secure, which is probably one of the reasons why we have a lot of MLSs still affiliated with ListHub. Some of the requirements our publishers have to abide by is when we send them the listing, it is just for consumer display. They can't use any of that data to benefit their metrics, you know, their estimation on price value of that property, nothing like that. It literally is packaged up into a little box, it's advertised on their website. And another thing that they have to abide by is once that listing becomes inactive, sells, you know, expires, whatever it changes in the MLS, we obviously pull from our dashboard within 24 hours, so all of those sites have to pull their listing or your inactive listing off their sites as well. You'll never have to worry about, and I know a lot of you probably have had this issue in the past, of a listing you sold several months ago still being active on one of these websites. So you will not have to ever worry about that with ListHub. Also, too, when we package your data and send it to these publishers, we package up even like the email address, contact information for the actual realtor or brokerage. All of these publishers have to basically showcase where this listing came from. Majority of all of them will actually say, you know, listing contributed or provided by, and it will say your brokerage name, and I'll show you kind of a really cool thing that we can do with that here in a bit. But all of that information is packaged up, and if on one of these websites it does say, you know, click here to contact listing agent or click here to see our listing agent's email, all that information is packaged up and delivered to all of these publishers. Any questions before I move on to the next slide? Yes. Yep.
Okay, so it basically is the websites that don't have
Well, so I'm going to kind of go piggyback off your main question. Maybe I'll answer other questions as well. But when it comes to leads from Zillow and Trulia, we don't push your listings to there. So, no, it's fine. I just wanted to say that because I know that's a question among people as well. And then, yeah, go on. We don't push your listings to Realtor.com. Realtor.com, they're a part of our network, but your listings go directly to Realtor.com from the MLS. Yes. Yes. Yep. If like there is somebody who advertised on the right hand side of Home Finder, that isn't the listing agent. I can't stop the way a consumer goes about contacting you all, but if it says click here to contact listing agent, that lead's going to go directly back to you. But say I'm a consumer, I go and I'm like, this guy looks really nice. Or actually, this name sounds, I mean, this is how people think. Or, God, that last name sounds familiar, and it's somebody I went to high school with. I mean, if I'm living in the city, which I'm buying a house. Or, you know, at the same time, too, like they go eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Or they write down the property, and they call their best friend's husband, who happens to be a realtor. Unfortunately, I can't stop them from doing that. But when we advertise your listing online, there is an availability to actually say where the listing came from, the brokerage. Some of them will say the listing agent's name and potentially a phone number or the brokerage main line to call and say, hey, I found 2724 Burton Avenue. You know, obviously listed underneath your brokerage. Can you tell me who the listing agent is? I'm really curious to actually find out about this property. No, but the one thing that I always want to suggest to you is I've had a lot of brokers create list sub accounts and have not gone in and chosen the publishers. So then your listings aren't going, and I'm not saying that's the case for you, but sometimes some brokers are like, I'm not getting any leads. What are you doing? No one's calling about my properties, and then I log into their account, and they've deselected all the sites, and I'm like, that's why you're not getting any leads, because we're not advertising your listing online. Yes. So that is, I think, the next slide or two. So I like the, you're flowing with me real well, and I'll get to that in a second. Yes.
If we were to institute this process in our world, mm-hmm. you're our person to contact.
Yes.
To help feedback while we get set up rolling.
Yep, and I will, even in that email, will send you a 2-minute video that takes you step by step of setting this all up. So, but if you can't figure it out, that is what I'm here for. Now, if it's some really big technical issue, I might pass you on to support because I only know so much, but I know quite a bit now after being with the company for a couple years. But let's move on to how we actually create that account. But before I actually do that, I want to talk a little bit more about our publishers. So we have a pretty actually long-standing relationship with the Realogy Network, so the REN network of brokerages. Some of you who are sitting in this room today might be actually affiliated with some of those brands. But one thing we want to share with you guys is whether you're a mom-and-pop shop or you're maybe a competitor of one of these brands or you are a brand, the great thing about this is you guys can advertise your listings on these sites, and it kind of like levels the playing field. What if you go into a listing presentation and somebody's meeting with a REMAX broker or agent to say, you know, I actually met with a REMAX agent the other day about listing my property, but I wanted to meet with you. You can be like, great, REMAX is a great company. You know, yeah, they're well known in the area. And actually, I'm going to be able to advertise your listing on REMAX.com too. So if you're interested in going with me, you're going to get that exposure that, of course, they promised you to get your listings on REMAX.com. So that's one of the issues, one of the benefits of this, of having it as well. But you don't have to select these publishers if you don't want to. If I have anyone who's REO, who's basically listing agent for Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, we are the exclusive to get your listings to HomePath and HomeStep. So if there's anyone here sitting in the room today or whoever eventually listens to this webinar, you're probably already familiar with ListHub because it's the exclusive to how to advertise your listings on those sites. Do I have anyone that is a part of Keller Williams or the Realogy Networks, any of these brands in the white box here present today? Which one? ERA. If you guys want to stick around at the end of the presentation, do you still do duplicate entry into Crest and the MLS? Okay, well, we have a product that will eliminate for you that is directly built by ListHub and Realogy together, something we've been working on for several years, and it's finally happening. So if you can stick around for a couple minutes after the presentation, you'll be good to go. So how to actually participate, take control of your ListHub dashboard, go to listhub.com. The screen right here on this girl smiling because she's so happy to be on ListHub, that's actually our front page of our website, so it will look very familiar when you go to it. On the right-hand side, you'll see create an account, or it might just say create account. Now, there'll be two options. There'll be a broker option and an agent option. Obviously, for you all, go take the broker option route because you are the managing broker. It will ask you to fill out a form, verify that you're the head broker. It shouldn't take you more than 5 minutes. Create a username and password. There might actually be many of you, because when I looked through the account, there were a lot of brokerages in this association that have already taken the initiative to have a username, basically, so they already have access to it. If you think that's the case, go in and just try to log in, and I might ask for your email address. They forgot password, and see if it will send you a password, and maybe you set this up a year ago or 2 years ago. And also, too, I see this so often. What happens if you had an office admin or somebody in the office set this up on your behalf several years ago, and you have no idea? And I can even, after the presentation, look up people's accounts as well. So I promise you, before you walk out of this door, you guys will know exactly where you stand with ListHub. Any questions on participating, creating your account, or anything? How many of you guys currently actually have, like, you know for a fact that you have a ListHub account even at the basic level? Quite a few of you. How many of you guys, maybe, I think I do, but not quite sure. Okay, good. Well, for the ones that are like, not quite sure, come see me after the presentation. So when you guys create your ListHub account, or maybe some of you created it and haven't taken this step, or at some point maybe not have selected all of the publishers, go into, these are the only four tabs you'll see on the actual dashboard when you log in. If you click on Publishers and Publisher Choices, this is where you're going to see all the publishers you can select. There will be a green button that says Maximize Marketing. So instead of clicking each individual publisher, you can click Maximize Marketing and be able to go to all of them. We do have filters for publishers as well. You guys are the brokers. We're at ListHub. We're not going to tell you, hey, you have to go to these sites. So we give you filters to kind of weed out maybe some sites you're not really, you know, fond of, or if you want to be a little bit more selective. But every time I pick up a phone and I'm talking to a broker and I pull up their account, 9 out of 10 times, and most of the time every single day, everyone goes to every available publisher, because if we're advertising the most accurate source of information, why would you want not that? Why would you not want to have that exposure? Because you never know where your consumer is going to start their internet search for their home. For all of you too, when you have that ListHub account and it's active and we're pushing your listings out to these sites, we're going to send you a broker awareness email. It's basically a reminder, because the great thing about ListHub at the basic level is once you guys set it up and pick your publishers, you don't have to log into it every day. You don't even have to log into it every month. It is there to work while you work and do your own thing without you actually having to manage it whatsoever. So we'll send you a little screenshot or a snippet of how you guys are doing online. We'll say how many listings that we're currently distributing for you. We'll show you basically the number of listings we distributed the month before, so you can see if maybe you added as a brokerage level 20, 10, 2 more listings in the last 30 days. We'll also remind you how many publishers you have selected, a data protection, because all of those data protections I talked about that all these publishers have to abide by, we want to keep them honest. So we're constantly making sure that they're updating their website, that they're pulling them down in a timely manner. And then we'll give you kind of just a little bit of a view of data of your account. We'll tell you out of the 184 listings, over 21,000 people physically clicked on those listings in a 30-day period. And then the same with February. We'll show you the month before. So then you can kind of see the growth of your company. You can see the activity. You can kind of know, all right, March was a really good month for us. Maybe we did something different in March that we should do in the coming months. Of course, kind of make that for August and into September. Now that when we took this screenshot, I can't believe how fast this year is going. So the other tab that you guys, if you want to play around with on the basic level, is your inventory tab. If you guys all click that, it's going to showcase all of the active listings for your entire office. So whether you are a brokerage with, you're the only person in your brokerage and you only hold 2 listings, you'll see all 2 listings. If you're a broker with 20, 30 agents and hold about 100 listings, you'll see all 100 listings in there. And this was a question that was brought up before the presentation, but we pull commercial, residential, lots, lands, rental properties, anything that you put into the MLS, we pull into and obviously showcase underneath this inventory tab. Yes?
If we have a unique status here, mm-hmm. we pending or under contracts, we still showing is this just active listings, or is it listings that are still being shown but have a contract?
It will be listings that are still shown. If it's pending or under contract, but once that status changed to sold, expired, or you just pull the listing off for some reason, the seller backs out, then we pull it off. That's when we pull it off all those sites.
Now, is it shown? Of course, your other publishers don't always pick up those distinctions. So is it showing an active?
There are some publishers, because not every website is created the same, because you got to remember, like, when the web vendor comes in or that says, okay, we're going to build this website for you, they have, like, certain templates, so it's basically feeding data in. Some will show under contract or pending, and some might just say active, and then all of a sudden, once that's sold, it just takes off. There was no pending. There was no, like, buffer in-between period. Every publisher is very, very different in that case because, again, like I said, of Home Finder obviously probably put more money in building their website and having a template as opposed to, like, eLookyLoo, which is a smaller site in some regions. I have a lot of people actually look at sites like that, but it's smaller. It might not have as much detailed information. Just like with virtual tours, guys. If you put the virtual tour link inside, obviously, the data of the listing for the into the MLS, some of our publishers will support that virtual tour link. So click here for virtual tour, and they'll click it. But some publishers might not. So if I go to eLookyLoo, and there's not a link for virtual tour, and I call you, I mean, you might say, hey, did you check out the virtual tour? I'm like, no, I didn't see it. So there's just going to be some sites that support. But for the very bare minimum, of course, they're going to have all of the photos, all of the property information, the remarks, you know, any of the information that you guys put into the MLS that's obviously crucial to hopefully sell this home.
How are you going to feel if I like to direct my clients to ppar.com?
Okay.
If you look on the first listing, uh-huh. and eventually get to the photographs,
uh-huh.
You don't have any issue with that?
No. I want people to look at your listings, but if there's a client that you're working with and you direct them, but if I don't know you, you can't direct me to you know, the association's website. So if I go to realtor.com or homes.com and I find your listing that way and I call your office or call you, then you then after can say, hey, go to our website, because if you're still looking for a three-bedroom, three-baths home within this price range, look at all these listings. I do have another product throughout the end of the presentation that I think is really beneficial that can actually help you communicate with those potential clients as well. So I have like a tickle in my throat now. Some other benefits to your basic free account with ListHub. I encourage brokers, if you have the time or if you have an office admin that can help you out with this, is upload your logo, because if you ever participate in any of the upgrades with ListHub and or even if your agents do, it's going to have everything branded with your brokerage logo, so it's just a benefit. And guys, it takes like 2 seconds to upload your brokerage logo. You can invite agents. I don't want agents to be calling you, knocking on your door, texting you, emailing you, hey, are our listings going? Where are our listings going? Can you give us a list? You know, how do I get logged into ListHub? If you just go in and invite all the agents, every agent in your office will get a generated email to invite them to go in and create a username and password since you already have a ListHub account. I'm going to show you how we can route leads in a different way in the next slide. So instead of jumping to that website or what we call redirect traffic, it's website redirect. As I mentioned a couple slides ago, we say where the listing comes from, you know, Colorado Springs Executive Real Estate or whatever your brokerage name is. We can actually link that back to your brokerage website at no cost. If this is something you're interested in, it's just a way to organically get more traffic to your site from somebody who might be looking at one of the websites or one of the publishers within our network. I'm not saying it's going to up your website to be the number one search engine on Google. I'm not going to say it's going to bring 1,000 people in the first minute to your site. But again, if they leave any of our publishers, I really want them to stay focused on your brokerage, that specific listing, and be able to call you directly, or at least call your office to get a hold of you. So what I want to talk about when I said lead generation or redirect leads, this is not something you have to do. So if you all don't listen to a word I say in the next 30 seconds to a minute, if you don't do anything with this, what will end up happening if there is ever an option on any of our publishers that says click here to contact listing agent or send web inquiry to listing agent, that lead will go back to that email address of that listing agent that's provided to us via the MLS. Now, say you go in and you want to actually set up this lead management. You can put a lead email and a lead phone number, and that will override every email and every phone number that we obviously get generated from the MLS. So we've seen some brokers do that because you guys might actually work with a lead generation company where you basically have a software implemented into your brokerage that when that lead comes in, it might auto-respond or it might kick to somebody in the office that can set up a schedule or an appointment with the listing agent who might be busy. So you can do this. You do not have to do this. So this just means all the leads to the office will get generated to that email and that phone number. You can allow agents to override it. Maybe you have several agents in the office that are on top of their game. I mean, even if a lead comes in at 11 o'clock at night, they're pretty much on top of it to respond back. Or you can just not touch this at all, but it is under your basic account. Any questions on the basic level before we move on? Yes. Okay, good question. So the question was, what's the difference between the functionality and things that you guys have offered between a broker and agent dashboard with ListHub? Well, the broker dashboard, you're going to have the control to pick all the publishers. And then, of course, you're going to see all of the office's listings, not just your listings. Now, if I'm an agent within your office and I log into my ListHub account, I can't select or deselect publishers. I will only see my listings. And then it's another benefit, too, if I create that username and password and I have my own login credentials, if I ever have an issue, I don't have to go through the broker. I can go directly to my ListHub account and put in a support request or call and say, username Lauren Whitney Hill, I'm having an issue. My listing is for some reason not populating. I have 10. I only see 9. Help me out. So that's really the only difference, the functionality. But it's really, in essence, doing the same thing. It's pushing your listings out to all the sites that you select as the broker. Good question. And there'll be different functionalities, too, when I talk about any of the upgrades as well. Out of curiosity, because I don't know your guys' area a little bit, and I know some of you, but does anyone in this room, have you guys worked with international, like, investors or buyers within this? I know that you guys obviously have properties that would attract them, but sometimes I always like to ask that question because sometimes people in the audience have never worked with an international buyer. So I'll probably get through this pretty quickly. I didn't give you guys this handout because sometimes it might not be relevant to a lot of you, but I like sharing this with everyone because it just opens your eyes to a lot broader than just advertising your listings domestically. So we do have a product called ListHub Global. It's the exact same thing as I talked about the last 20 minutes about our domestic publishers, but we do it internationally too. So to kind of give you an inside look of some international opportunity for these investors and obviously buyers coming into the U.S., total market for this 2015 year is estimated to be $104 billion, which is a 13% increase from last year. I think last year was about, $92.2 billion. In some markets, it's up to 30% of the transactions, obviously 8% nationwide. I'm telling you guys, I have brokers and agents across the U.S. from really small cities to obviously well-known cities, and it's not just luxury properties because you're seeing these investors and these buyers coming in to diversify portfolio. A lot of times investment properties, vacation properties, retirement properties, a lot of times if they're relocating a corporate headquarters here, you just never know, or they're just investing in something to maybe the market's great to turn around and sell it and make a profit off of it. So I want to talk about this opportunity with ListHub Global. So it's a network of trusted sites that meet our same publisher requirements and all of the safe and secure accurate information because it's still MLS connected. This is an upgrade, or not technically an upgrade, but just an add-on. It's an additional service. And what ends up happening is it's still MLS connected. So this is a broker opt-in. An individual agent can participate in this. When you opt into ListHub Global, we partnered with a company called List Globally, very similar to us, to do the translation and currency conversion to obviously advertise your listings on these sites internationally. We have over 70 international publishers and growing. That's why if you ever see any of our marketing material online, we always say 70 plus because we add to it all the time. So eventually you might see 80 plus or 90 plus. To talk about some of our publishers, we have the largest website in China, which actually gets the most views out of any international website there is for real estate. It gets more unique visitors than Zillow, Trulia, and Realtor.com combined in a day in the U.S. If you guys have some time, check it out. It's a pretty mega website, of course, unless you can speak Chinese, change it into the translate it into English. If not, you're going to be really confused because it's a lot of information. No, you can change that into any language that you want. There's a drop-down menu. Most of the time, too, for any maybe computers that are made in the last 2, 3, 4 years, it actually will ask you it right away, so you don't even have to go that route. I know my computer is like a 2-year-old Mac, and anytime I go to any of our international sites, it just asks me if I want to translate it, and it does. We also have the number one property website in the UK. It actually ranks above their BBC, which is their leading news source. And then I guess in the last probably 12 to 14 months, Russians have had a huge impact in the transactions here in the U.S. 1.2 million unique visitors on that site. Russians invest in about $12 billion a year in real estate abroad. These are three out of the 70-plus publishers. I think these are our most prominent ones, but we obviously have many more. We have them in Germany. We have the very long, long list. And if you guys are interested in this, on that handout I have for global syndication, it has all the countries of which we send your listings to. If this is something you guys participate in, we will give you branded marketing collateral to take into, especially a listing that you feel would be, you know, if you're going into listing presentation of a really great property that might wow the seller, that you can say, hey, I can advertise your listing internationally, and these are the countries of which I will advertise. We're not going to just try to get a buyer here in Colorado or in the U.S. We're going to try to get buyers out internationally. We also will give you an interactive global map as well. Take this into a listing presentation. Put the link on your website, on your social media. If you hover over the state of Colorado, it's going to show you the top 5 countries of exactly where these investors are and buyers are coming in. 90% of the time when I look at this map, all of those countries are covered within our ListHub Global network. Also, too, I guarantee you guys are going to get this question from your client saying, I want to see what my listing looks like on Feng. I want to see what my listing looks like in Russia. Well, instead of you guys having to spend 15, 20 minutes going to the site, translating it, searching for the listing, copy and pasting, emailing it, you'll get an email or a ListHub dashboard for your global listings to give you direct links to those sites. So especially the first kind of couple of weeks, you have this listing going out to all these international publishers. Send a few of those links to your clients. Show them, hey, as I promised you, we're showcasing your listings on these three sites as well as 70 other publishers. This is the pricing. We don't need to go over it too much because, like I said, it might not pertain to all of you. There is a $69 a month minimum. It is a month-to-month basically commitment with us. You are not locked in and into a contract for the rest of your life with ListHub. You guys can cancel it at any time. We can be flexible. We don't have to do your entire inventory. If you say, listen, Lauren, there's only 20 properties in our brokerage that I think would maybe be attractive, we can do your top 20 listings and charge you for just that. You can call me the next month and say, we need to up to 25 because we just got 6-7 new more properties, and I think about 4 or 5 of them would be really relevant. We're very flexible. Also, too, we offer a discount for anyone who has a CIPS designation, helps you guys do transactions, technically certified to do transactions with international buyers and investors, gives you some insight information. We have a 10% discount. It's basically an education class that you can take through NAR. If you guys are kind of interested in it, go to NAR or just Google CIPS NAR, and I'm sure all that information will actually be provided for you. I will say the only person I've really talked to who's taken the class in the last couple months is my mom, and she says it's really educational, and she doesn't even sell property. She's the MLS director out in Las Vegas. So you are CIPS? Was the class, was it worthfile?
CIPS.
Okay.
Pre-CIPS, mm-hmm. Something that was local.
Okay.
But for international, I've worked with investors already.
Okay.
And 40 kind of got initially put into.
Yeah.
International context, mm-hmm. And knowing I need to go to the next.
Yeah. I mean, if any of you guys are starting to basically, you know, dabble a little bit into it, I know it's a beneficial class. I'm always about furthering education. I'm sure your association is exactly like that too.
A very low-cost way to get a couple units and find out if it's for me. Then at education, they have a really good basic, and it gives you incredible information about protocols for working with various international buyers because their cultures are very different.
Oh, yeah, like during the CIPS designation, it will tell you in what countries that you do not speak to the female, that you only speak to the male about properties. So there's a lot of, I mean, I think it's great information. I wish I could take it, but I can't until I get more on the realtor side. Okay. Well, let me know how it goes because, of course, I like feedback because then I share it with, you know, additional brokers and agents across the country. So, okay, we're talking about all this exposure here in the U.S. Internationally, if that's something you guys are interested in. So we're advertising your listings, and what happens after you advertise your listings? Fingers crossed, people call you. They want to look at your listings. So how are we going to route and consolidate leads? Not so much in live presentations because some people are scared to answer this question, but I always ask when I'm on the phone with some of my clients, like, what are your biggest, because I want to get to know you guys, like, what are your biggest concerns? What are your biggest hiccups? What do you struggle with the most as an individual agent or broker? I hear a lot of the times I struggle with managing my leads, following up with them. I get a lead in, and the next day I'm talking to them, but they've already contacted 3 other agents within that time period. To give you kind of a staggering number, and this is in the real estate industry, 75% of leads are lost. Think about it. I mean, I have not been on my computer all day. If there was an email that came in that says, Lauren, I need you ASAP, that client's already probably pretty frustrated with me, even though I have my auto response saying I'm not in the office for the next couple days. But with you guys, it's the same thing. You're at listing presentations. You're in this presentation. You might even be on a vacation for a couple days, and you're trying to disconnect because as a realtor, I know your guys' jobs is around the clock 24/7. You don't technically have a weekend or a day off unless you really try to take it off. So how are we going to minimize this number? How are we going to make it where, for at least your brokerage and for you individually, where none of your leads are lost? Well, there's kind of a magic number. If you respond within the first 5 minutes of that lead coming in, you are going to increase your contact rate by 900%. We live in a world of now, I want now, where I will be honest with you guys, I'm that person. I am needy. I need it now. I got a dog several months, actually almost a year ago, and moved into a new house. Anyone who has a little puppy dog, potty training sometimes isn't the easiest. So it took me a while, but we're okay now, but I wanted my carpet shampooed. True story, I called 4 or 5 carpet cleaners and found out the one that could either come that day or the next day because I could not last one more day looking at my carpets. That's just how consumers are, and the same thing with the real estate industry. I can't tell you how many times when I get to this part of a slide or if I'm doing a demo over the phone, an agent would tell me, oh, I get emails from clients, all caps, call me now, I need to look at this property today. Like, not, hey, how are you? Like, how's it going? I'm interested in your property. A little more formal and welcoming. So we all know that people need that auto response now. Well, we don't want to measure the fact that you guys are responding to this in hours and days. We need to now measure it in minutes. And again, 5 minutes is the key ticket. So in order to respond within 5 minutes, we have a company or product called Five Street. Crazy that it's called Five Street. To help you guys with that. So really how Five Street works, I basically explain it as your mini virtual assistant that's out there. You can name it who, whatever you want. But this virtual assistant is going to manage, consolidate, engage to your leads, do everything for you without actually you having to do a thing. Now, say you get a lead generated from Realtor.com or from Zillow. Five Street works with all the publishers within our network and plus some. So say you get a lead from Realtor.com. If you happen to be on your phone, because Five Street will text you and also email you that lead, if you're on your phone and you see it instantly, you just claim it, you call that person right away. Five Street will scour the internet, find out their email, their phone number. Sometimes it will even show you social media links, LinkedIn links, information about properties they're looking at. So in that case, when you pick up that phone call and call them right back, you kind of have a good idea of who you're already working with. Now, say you're busy. You can't claim that lead right away via email or your text message. Well, after 5 minutes, Five Street steps in and sends an auto response to them that you guys can set up. So it doesn't have to look very auto response-y, if that's an actual word. Like if you email me right now, it's very auto response-y. Hey, I'm out of the office. Please leave me an email. If it's an emergency, call this number. But under your Five Street dashboard, like during office hours from 8 to 5 or 8 to whatever your office hours are, you can say, you know, I'm currently unavailable or with a client right now. Is there a way you can either email me or text me a good time to call you sometime today? If today doesn't work out, let me know what your next availability and I'll call you as soon as possible. Say you want to do kind of post office hours. You know, I'm not currently in the office right now. Is there a way that I can call you by 9 o'clock tomorrow if you continue your home search this evening or throughout the rest of the day? Write down any properties. I'd be happy to talk about the properties you find and any other listings that I can show you. Yes.
Do you have any consumer feedback on how they respond to that kind of message?
So the only consumer feedback I can give you is what the agents who use Five Street, and this is the only example that I have, because ListHub has actually, since we're kind of cousin companies, we've really only been selling Five Street for couple months because they don't have Five Street reps that physically come to you guys. So they asked us, like, hey, can you sell some of these products or at least expose these products to these potential clients that you meet with? So the only ones I know are the ones I've sold in the last couple months. I do have one agent that was in Hopkinsville, Kentucky, or Tennessee. Morphed together because Kentucky's not my, or Tennessee's not my territory, but Kentucky is. It's a long story. So anyway, I did have an agent because I put that process through and has called me back and says that when she's in meetings or a listing presentation and she, you know, doesn't claim it and she sees it comes through, that she just sends a simple text because think about it, people don't have that many landlines anymore. Everyone's working off their cell phone. Granted, some of you might. I actually have a landline at home for work. But for the most part, text them, you know, or this agent said, I had a texting conversation back and forth. I could not actually pick up the phone and call them, but I wanted to know that I'm engaged and I want them to know and call them and started communication. I haven't followed up to see if that client actually converted into a potential transaction for that property, but that's something that we do see a lot. Yes. No, not necessarily. If you get the bundle, so with Five Street and some market snapshot, if you work with a Realtor.com rep or a top producer rep, they can sell you different packages as well. Mm-hmm. But it isn't always, like if you work with Realtor.com, you don't automatically get Five Street. You got to opt into it. Yeah. So you're paying it somehow, some way. You just might not know it. It might be bundled up in a package somehow. So that's like the great part about it. And then it's actually going to keep you emailed updates. So instead of actually having to go back to your computer and navigate and go through all of the 20, 30 emails that you've missed since you've been sitting here, you'll have one email from Five Street telling you all this information. You can log into your Five Street dashboard and basically build your Rolodex of potential buyers. The great thing about it too is it's going to give you even beyond information, you know, giving you kind of a week-by-week breakdown of how many leads you're generating. You know, maybe you're starting to do some maybe advertising efforts on HomeFinder, Realtor.com, whatever site it may be. Well, maybe in week 37 you did that and it worked. You know, and say for example it popped down to down here for week 38. Well, if you only did it for 1 week and then your traffic or your leads went even lower, then maybe what you did for week 37 is something you should constantly do. So showing you guys if other marketing and advertising tactics you're doing, is it actually working? Also, too, if any of you guys work in a team, 5 Street is also a great product for that. So we've seen a lot of agents kind of partner up because the demand sometimes of listings and to have somebody kind of co-list with you or kind of help you through this process is almost sometimes great too. So if you have this and I, myself, and my team member, you know, Sarah, are on the same team, we sell properties, and a lead comes in for Sarah's listing, but Sarah's actually out of the office or busy, and this lead comes to me, I can claim it, and then it's going to notify Sarah, hey, Lauren claimed the listing, she's actually contacting, and then once I've contacted, I can go into my dashboard and update information. Interested in the property, showing on, you know, August 6th, can't wait to meet her, super nice, looking for other properties, sending her an email instantaneously of more listings in the inventory. So kind of keeps you guys all tied together and in the loop. Any other questions on 5 Street before I move on? And again, we'll go through all the pricing at the very end of the presentation. Okay. Yes. Yeah, it's a dashboard. You basically create your own auto message. Yeah. You don't like with 5 Street. Well, with 5 Street too, I mean, it's automated, so you don't have to log into it every day. You just look for that text or that email. So, but of course, you can kind of be a little bit, you know, play around with the dashboard. If you guys participate in this, we give you the number to call the rep who actually trains you throughout this whole process. So I know 4 short slides in my presentation is not going to teach you guys enough to walk out this door, but of course we will make sure we hold your hand throughout this process. So now we've actually are communicating with these potential clients. Now, how are you going to communicate with past clients, buyers, sellers, people are showing interest? Well, 50% of online leads take more than 12 months to convert. So you're trying to build relationships that might last for the next couple year or the years to come. There is a product called Market Snapshot. Some of you are probably familiar with it. If not, it's exactly what it is. It is a snapshot of the market. It makes it look like you are the expert. And instead of kind of rolling off exactly like what it does, I'm going to give you examples of how the functionality of it is. So say you have a potential buyer you've been working with, sent a lead in, wasn't super aggressive about buying a property, just looking right now. Well, set them up for a market snapshot where this buyer will get a snapshot of all new active listings that go on the market. You can set it up to go to them weekly. Again, this is another automated product. You can have it send it out monthly where they constantly get a newsletter from you branded with all of your information, very personable, looks great even on a computer to a mobile application that says, hey, there's a new listing on the market. You set up the market snapshot to that particular client. So if you know this buyer is interested in this zip code or this area or just looking anywhere for a 3-bedroom, 2-bath within a certain price range, set them up for that market snapshot and they'll get those automated emails. Say you're working with a seller. Someone's kind of interested in selling their property but not quite sure, or maybe it's somebody you actually sold them a house many years ago and they're kind of thinking about potentially selling their property again. Send them a report, actually, and I'll show you an example. Send them something that says, hey, look, this house recently sold in your neighborhood. You know, the fact that, oh, this is a great price, this listing is pretty similar to ours and it's just as updated. Why couldn't we get a price like that for our property? So it's going to make them engage and call you because now maybe they're ready to buy or ready to sell, excuse me. Say, for instance, you're working with a seller who's interested in properties. Well, price changes, just listed, constantly communicating with them. We've had actual agents and brokers use this product far beyond since I've been selling it, and they have clients that they have in their Rolodex from 5, 10, 15 years ago that have a market snapshot that goes out to them either once a month or a couple times a year. And the great benefit to that is You're always on top of their mind. If they're going to sell or buy a house, they're going to remember you're sending them this newsletter. I also suggest, why don't you put this newsletter on the signature of your, when you email someone. Hey, are you interested in buying or selling? You want to see what's listed in the market and what things are selling for? Click here to sign up. They sign up, they put the frequency of which they want that newsletter. You guys just got an email and a potential lead, somebody who might be interested in buying or selling with you all. It's basically a drip marketing campaign that can basically manage any and all of the clients you're working with and potentially working with and worked with in the past, because you guys can't keep on top of helping people buy and sell homes, talk to hundreds of additional people a week or a month, and then, of course, like following up with all your leads. It's a lot of work. So with all this, it's absolutely automated. Any questions on Market Snapshot? There's usually one more slide there, but it didn't show up. Any questions on Market Snapshot before I move on? Another way to use this too, I actually had an agent that I sold this to not too long ago. When she does an open house now, she has an iPad or a tablet. She puts that out, people look at the property. You know, you grab a flyer, you look at it, you might be interested in it. But before they leave, they say, hey, if you actually can put your email address in there, if you want to, I can send you any properties that are like this that go on the market just to kind of keep you in the loop if this isn't your dream home. She just got 4, 5, 6 email addresses for having an open house and now is going to follow up with all those people with other listings that are exactly like that in the MLS. So that's what she did. She gave us that info back to us. Also, Market Snapshot will talk about school district and community information as well, so you can be pretty specific and you can be as detailed to as vague as you want, because maybe you're working with somebody who just wants a listing and needs to have it under $250,000 and you want to just send them anything and everything under the sun. You absolutely can do that. So I really don't want to forget the other really important person in your guys' lives, your sellers. These people are crucial, and a lot of the times they happen to sometimes be the neediest because they're selling their largest investment they ever made. It is sometimes a very tedious process. Sometimes it's not. Sometimes, you know, they just don't know what's going on, and they trust you, or they have to trust you in that sense. So I want to give you guys a tool to be able to attract and constantly engage with your current clients right now who are your sellers. So with ListHub, we have upgrades where you actually can have reporting and communication tools and a seller report that goes directly automatically. Everything I talk about today is automated because we don't want you guys to have to do more than you already have to do. But it's an automated seller report that's going to show the value you provide as a realtor and the value you provide to them for being their listing agent because you've advertised their listing online and because you're getting traffic from these websites. So you're going to be able to engage with your clients, demonstrate the value. It's going to help you win more listings, and it's going to also help you guys price properties, and I'll show you how to do this. So that report right there is called our seller report. If or when you guys upgrade as a brokerage, we basically generate a report for every single one of your active listings. Then thereafter, all of your agents will have access to their listings and, of course, this report for their listings. The greatest thing about this is it has a market comparison report. I know majority of you probably send potentially a realtor.com, maybe in the past a Zillow report to your clients. Yeah, it's great to show the value, to say, hey, you're advertising your listings here. This is how many views you got and this is how many leads you got. But I really want to show your seller how is your listing competing or comparing, however you want to use that word, with other listings in the market exactly like it. Because these are the listings that a potential consumer is going to be looking at. So if, say, a property is a 3-bedroom, 2-bath within a certain price range and there happens to be 30 listings in the MLS that are almost identical to it within that property zip code or area. Well, for this example, the market comparison, I mean, this listing's competing very well. It is probably getting majority of the traffic. If an agent has a potential buyer or a buyer puts in a lead on a website about this property, they're probably going to be looking at this property rather than all the other little properties around it. Now, what if you have a property, it's on the market, you see a report that looks like this. Great traffic, a lot of people interested, but then it bottoms out for a while. Well, if you look at it, okay, 2, 3, 4 weeks, it bottomed out, people aren't interested, other listings all around it are going either up on the market or getting sold. Take this into a conversation with your seller and have an easier way to talk about a price adjustment. Make that price adjustment, and then hopefully, voila, which we always see, a spike in interest. Now, if you have a report that looks like this, over 11 weeks, you see it kind of trickle down. If this is a seller who is not eager to move whatsoever, Let them stay on the MLS. Let them have their listing be on the market for several months or a year or more. But if this is an eager client to sell their property, talk about open houses, maybe some more marketing material, maybe a price adjustment. Think about, be creative of how we're going to gain more traffic to this listing to show interest among the agents within this MLS and, of course, amongst people online looking at this property as well. On this seller report, we also packaged some other data we think is important, how many actual people clicked on this property, how many leads were generated. It's all plopped down into an automated email. It already has a pre-written message. All you have to do is a one-time setup, seller first name, last name, email address, and you set it and forget it. You pick the frequency of which you want it to go. So say you pick the first of the month or every week, depending on the client. Again, you set that up, you set it and forget it. And for the life of the listing, they get this report. We'll send you a weekly reminder telling you your progress of setting these reports up as well. You can instantly print it off, you can instantly email, or you can actually log into your account and set up that automation. A part of the ListHub Pro upgrade, you'll also get branded marketing material. This is going to help you guys win presentations because, yeah, an agent can walk in and say, I'll advertise your listings online, but to show them your 900 website, your extended network, the fact that you're going to actually be able to show them and compare how their listing is competing in this market, which is information they can't get on their own. And lastly, a part of the Pro upgrade, you also get real-time reporting. Now, this is going to be a report that's going to be reflective of your entire brokerage. So how, as an entire office, are you doing, like, how are you doing online? On a month-to-month basis or a quarter-to-quarter basis, depending on how you want to look at this, you know, are you gaining listings? Are you gaining leads? Are you gaining traffic? Who's actually generating the most leads and the most traffic to your listings? Now, I know your MLS is still kind of in the works with a partnership with the Zillow Group, which includes Zillow and Trulia. If and when, how, whatever happens, we eventually can actually include the Zillow Group, which is Zillow and Trulia, reporting onto the metrics on a broker level, if that is something you guys want to do. If not, at the very least, you're getting all this metrics from all the publishers, and then, of course, to Realtor.com, but you're going to get more than that. You're going to see where your online consumers are located. You're really going to know, are people relocating from in-state, out-of-state, where are they coming from? So it really helps you guys figure out where you should market. You're also going to have a customizable report. Find out what listings in your inventory are the most sought out and what websites, what MLS number, so an exact listing gets the most traffic. Maybe that's a listing that we need to say we constantly need listings like this. Find out what zip code is the most sought out, what publisher brings you the most traffic. Even see the activity of your agents. Who's your top producing agent? How many leads do they get a month? What products or what are they doing to generate all these leads and traffic? So I know I threw a lot of information and I'm kind of running way over time. We're like at an hour. I apologize so much. But I promise you guys, whether you upgrade to any of these products or just stay at the basic level, we always have training availability for you all. We don't just take your credit card and throw you to the wolves whatsoever. But if you guys upgrade on a broker level, we do individual broker training where we actually have a webinar base where we train all of your agents, including yourself, in the office. And support is available for any level of participation with ListHub. Here is a breakdown, which we don't really have to go over, but is there any gray area of any of our products before I move on? You all have handouts that have all this information on it, but I want to try to get you guys out of here and then, of course, answer any questions. Okay. Let's go over pricing. So this is broker pricing. I'm going to break it down one by one. So for the ListHub Pro, it is based off the number of agents you have in the office. So if you have 14 agents, you're looking at $79 a month. That's not 79 times 14. When you pay 79, it's basically going to encompass all 14 agents within the office. It's a month-to-month. We do have a special buy 1 month, get 1 month free. Try it out for 60 days. If it's something that you guys don't want to use or you're not seeing results, by all means, I mean, we don't want you to use something that you're not using. So you can cancel at any time. You can also go annual and like actually lock into that pricing. It's really beneficial if you're a brokerage of like 18 agents. This is a great recruiting tool to get more agents into your office because you're going to offer these reports and marketing material. Then you can lock into the annual pricing as well. For a 5-street, it's based off the number of agents within your team. If you're an individual agent, you want to manage all of your leads and you're the only one that wants to do it, it will be $19 a month. There is an event pricing. It's usually $25. The only way to get this event pricing is to go through me. If you go to 5-street or you go to ListHub, you will not see that special pricing. So because you guys are here today. It is an event special only. You walk out this door and do nothing right now. Please email me if you want to participate in any of these products. And then with Market Snapshot, it's usually $64.95 a month, but your special is $55.95 a month. Now, I will say for these two products, if you individually do that, sometimes there are your contracts that you have to actually abide by. So, but if you guys have any questions on that, I have one more slide I want to throw at you guys, and then I'm done. I will let you guys go about your day. I had a question. How many, if you guys are willing to share, maybe not, I know there might be some of you that are just one-man show. You are a brokerage, and you might be the only agent or one of the only agents in the office that would utilize any like anything like this. Well, we do offer something different, and this is what I present into the agent presentation as well. If you are a broker and you are only concerned with yourself and you are maybe the only agent in your office, we can give you all of those products for a bundle for $75 a month. So you can get all three of these in a bundle, $75 per month. You'll get the reporting, you'll get the automated response to all of your leads, and be able to send that market snapshot to anybody in your portfolio. If you are an agent and say, I don't technically need Market Snapshot or Five Street, I don't want to do the bundle, and you just want to go with ListHub Pro, those are $129 for the year for an individual agent. Does that make sense? If you are a small brokerage or it's just individually you, come back and talk to me. Or if you want to, right next to your name, agent, I can also send you some additional agent handouts as well. I just don't know how many I'm getting in the next presentation, and I don't have a lot of handouts if all 70-plus agents show up. So that's all I have for you guys today. I apologize. I know we digressed with some conversations and stuff like that, but I appreciate great feedback, great questions. I am here, obviously. I have another presentation, so come hither if you have specific questions. If you guys want to upgrade, there is that form. You guys can fill it out, and I will go, and that's my homework for tonight and tomorrow, is to get you guys up and running. Pro Plus, we don't include that Pro Plus, guys, in the presentation far often because it's not always relevant to everyone in the room. With Pro Plus, we can include your website metrics, your broker website metrics, onto the report. So if you want to actually showcase the value to your sellers and say, hey, we're getting this many clicks, this many leads from our website, it shows the value that you're providing at the brokerage. If you want to, you can email that